I quit my high-paying job in the tech industry and moved to Montana to pursue my dream of starting my own whiskey distillery. Just around $25,000 to my name and a few pieces of equipment I brought with me, we're starting from scratch. Will our whiskey distillery be successful? We'll find out. This is Whiskey RP.
Hello, spring is here, and today we're looking at this field, and I wanted to take a look at it. It looks like they planted sugarcane here, and apparently Richard is looking to sell this land. So I'm going to get on the phone with the realtor and see if we can make a deal for that. It'd be really nice to have a field that's already prepped for us for our sugar intake for the year. Then we could do a few other things with our two fields that we haven't planted yet. Let's get on the phone. So we've gone ahead and got this purchased, and there's some work that needs to be done on it. Still some fertilization and some weed growth that we need to take care of, and I think we'll take care of that with the weeder today. Let's go ahead and get some equipment prepped. All right, we got the Case Magnum warming up. We got to, you know, it's a little warm or cool this morning, so we're going to get that warmed up. Let's head on over here. I think we want to get the New Holland set up on the weeder, potentially, and take care of all of those weeds. Get the plow removed from that. We'll get the New Holland all prepared. I want to take a look at the weeder and make sure it's in good shape still. Yeah, taking a look here. It looks pretty good. I think we'll be all right with that. So let's see. Do things in the right order. The case has been warming up. Let's get it attached to the planter. Got one more bag of seed over here we can go through before we have to buy more. And let's go ahead and just top off the hoppers here. All right, we got it all prepared. We're gonna put cotton down. We're definitely gonna have to place some harvesting equipment this year for sugar canes and cotton as well. But money might be looking pretty good by then to where we don't have to lease. So we'll get this all set up and opened up and take a look at it, see how it's doing. Very fancy piece of equipment here. Things looking good. Just checking on all of it here. Let's hop on over to the other side. Looking pretty good. We'll get it lowered down just to make sure. Yeah, those levels look just about right. We'll have to take a sample after we get started too, but let's let that keep warming up. Let's go back to the New Holland. Do the same thing with the weeder here. Get it all opened up and make sure, oh, this beast is huge. That is right. Looks like that will definitely take care of the weeds for us. We'll have one of our employees take that for us, and it still says it needs, no, it doesn't. It clears up. Nice. So the weeds will be taken care of. Enjoy, and we'll take care of planting. Head on back over to the case and get rolling. This turned on here. Let's see how it goes. I believe we're planting. Let's take a look here. Yeah, you can see the rows just barely going in there. So I think we're all calibrated up right. Yeah, digging into the ground just the right amount there. We can get the measuring stick out, but I think we're good. And we're taking care of the fields first before the new grass field that we need for some of our other plans. The grass field was going to be just extra income. So we'll definitely make sure we get that done when we have a chance. But I wanted to get cotton into the ground this month, get the new sugar cane field all treated, and we'll see if we can do some fertilization on that now. We might have to wait till April for that, but let's get this field all planted, and then we could get the weeder over here next, or we could spray. We'll figure that out. And just getting the end rows done up here to make it easier to turn around once we're doing ups and downs. Sneak over just right there. It'll be real fun seeing cotton growing on our farm, and definitely will help out the new clothing business. And again, the sugar canes will help with everything whiskey, with the yeast factory turning it in, you know, into yeast, and then also selling the sugar for extra profit. We'll see if sugar cane's better than sugar beets when it comes to the return. Be interesting to find out. We've done two end rows here on the east side of the field. That should really help with turning around and avoiding hitting the sawmill when that time comes. And we'll do the same down on the west side of the field after we finish this pass and head back on down there. And we're doing the west end row as well here. This really set us up for some nice up and downs, nice easy way to turn around without damaging any other crops or getting into any other fields. Just gives us a nice runway for this large planter to turn around. Now that we got the end rows done, we're doing the east and west passes here. Would be the way we're gonna finish, just up and down about, you know, maybe 20 times, and it'll be done. Hopefully we have enough seed. We'll have to check that in a little bit to see how it's doing. I think we're going to run out and have to purchase some more, though. We'll see how that goes. Well, we just ran out of seed, and we do have Billy. We sent Billy, one of our workers, down to get some seed. So hopefully they're going to get there fine and get back here. All right, there's Bobby. He's making his way back now. Let's go check on the New Holland and see how they're doing with the weeding. All finished. Looking great. New field's looking awesome. We'll have to check the soil here in a little bit and see if we need to lime it next time. It's too late for that. We don't want to put lime down after we've already planted. So let's go ahead and get this home and potentially start... Yeah, we'll start it on the cotton field here. Should be getting there about the same time Bobby does, it looks like. You know, it'll be interesting to see what the yield is like on these crops. This is the first time we're doing the fertilization in the winter like we did to help us prep. And we're going to go ahead and have Bobby take this over. Good luck, Bobby. We got a good amount of bags of seed here. They're going to last us quite a while. All right, that should be good. We don't want to get too many cotton seeds in here. Go ahead and get it back unfolded, and we can pick up where we left off. And we should be, in plenty of time ahead of Bobby over there. But one of the things he was telling me about was there's this large John Deere for sale. It's about 60% off. So after I finish this up, we're going to potentially go take a look at that. He's telling me he doesn't think it's a deal that I could pass up. So we'll go ahead and take a look at that just in a few. I just want to get this done so we know we're done for the day in case I'm distracted by, you know, a new purchase and have time spent at the dealership working on the logistics of that. All right, all done. Let's get this folded up and we're going to clean it up. We're going to prepare it for planting corn next month. It's not time yet to get corn in the ground, so we are going to put that in the field that was sugar beets last year. So we'll get this home, and then it's time to head over to that dealership and see about this amazing tractor that he was telling me about. All right, just get this all cleaned up here, making sure we're taking care of our equipment so it lasts us a long time. It's expensive implements. We don't want them to get damaged and ruined and rusted and aged. Looking good. Let's spray the tractor down too while we're here. Get it nice and shiny again. Beautiful. I'm sure this John Deere 4020 would not mind a newer model sibling tractor around. Let's get the truck, get the seed put away, and we'll head on over to the dealership. All right, let's go chat with them and see what they have. We should have washed the truck while we're at it. Yeah, let's have a good conversation here. So this John Deere 8RT series has 458 horsepower. We had them do a couple tweaks to it to make it better for the United States here and add a GPS, and it's going to cost us $153,000. And this is a very expensive piece of equipment, and I cannot pass that. All right, so they got it pulled out. We'll get the truck later. I'm definitely going to drive this home. We're going to get it right into the shop and do a little bit of maintenance on it. Not sure exactly what we'll use this for yet, but be nice for planting the corn. We can give it a shot with that, and we can get some bigger equipment too. Be able to cultivate a lot faster. This thing is large. Plenty of room in the cab. We can have a passenger with us in here. Very, very nice. Couldn't pass up on a deal on that. Let's look up how much this is brand new. So one with similar specs that we had would have cost us $408,000. So I definitely think this was a wise decision. We got, you know, almost 70% off on this thing, and it's got, you know, 24 hours on it, which isn't too bad, not too beat up, but hopefully they maintained it well. We'll do an oil change on it, grease it on up, make sure everything's looking good before we use it on any jobs here. But yeah, we'll get it to the workshop and I'll, you know, do a look over it, figure out what kind of parts we got to order to get it completely ready to be used on the farm. All right, we'll leave it there. This is very exciting. Love getting new equipment. Gonna head on over to the cotton field and put some more fertilizer down. We should be able to work with the weeder there and not run into them. They should be, Bobby's making great time over there. It's already about halfway done. Perfect. Let's get this opened up. Hoping with the way we did our prep this year that this just goes on nice and we just have to worry about, you know, waiting for it to grow at this point. You know, we've taken care of the weeds, we've planted it, taken care of fertilizer. Should be all set. Switched over to this side so we don't run into each other, and hopefully Bobby sees us back here when he turns around. We might have a little issue here. I might have to pull back and let him pass. Yeah, let's do that so we don't interrupt too much. We'll get out of the way. let Bobby get past, and we can pick up where we were. Almost planned that, right? Not too bad. And we should be clear. Get locked in here. We'll back on up. Yeah, this is such a good purchase. Now just finishing the row that we skipped to avoid Bobby, and we should be all done with the cotton field being prepped, especially once the weeding's done. It'd be fun to just come check this out every once in a while and see how the cotton's growing, our first time with a new crop. All right, let's get the weeder all cleaned up too. You know, the case we did buy brand new, but we're a little timid after, you know, the arrest for stealing or buying a stolen vehicle and or tractor. And that, you know, that's why we did it officially from the dealership this time. We're staying away, even if we see titles. We're staying away from private party sales. Let's get the weeder put away. It's nice and clean now. And we're gonna get the spreader and prepare the new grass field with some lime and hopefully get it planted today as well. Yeah, we'll get this all prepped for planting and talk to you in a few. Well, we got a couple bags delivered here. Should be enough once both of these are in. Probably a little more than enough. And we'll go ahead and get this all finished liming. All right, that should be more than enough grass seed. So this will be interesting to see if this is too big of a planter for this area. We don't have the little one anymore, so this will have to do. Lower it up. Let's go ahead, turn it on. And grass should be going in here real nice. And we're getting as close as we can to the vines and feel comfortable with it. We're not going to be able to really get the mower that close, though. So right here will probably be as close as we want to get. And we'll just finish this pass. And I think that's going to be all we're going to have time to do in March. We'll finish the spring planting here in April. But what a productive day. All set here. Let's get this put away. We'll get it cleaned up and then we'll have a nice dinner and relax for the rest of the night. Like I said, very productive March. Didn't get too dirty, but might as well clean it up. Same with the case here. Couple spray down there. On over this side. Very, very good. Gotta take care of the equipment. Let's just get the case under cover here. Care of it there. Yeah, that's gonna do it for this episode. Very productive. We bought a new piece of land, a new piece of equipment. Got all of our fields prepped in the fields that we wanted to take care of in March. We're just looking good. Looking real good to be, I don't know, probably millionaires in a few months. Yeah. I'm Socks Way Up. I'll catch you on the next episode.